I'm gonna have to do this, aren't I? Very well.
What's up, guys? Titanium Chief here. And last week, I made a bet with a friend that if Future Orca lost the faction rally of that week, I had to make this video. And well,
we have New Monarchy as the faction rally winner.
Damn it.
The reason I chose to do ASMR is because Carnell kept suggesting that I'm the type of person to do ASMR. But seriously, Carnell, why the fuck do you want me to do this so badly? And I thought that this would be rather humiliating, so here I go. You might think I'm gonna do this by doing what Markiplier did 5 fucking times. But actually, I'm just going to read a bunch of stuff and hope to God no one gets turned on by this. Since the bit was about Destiny, I'm going to read some Destiny things, and I'll start with the Faust Auric Strike opening dialogue. I actually know this by heart, and I'll prove that by putting on some blindfolds, which also gives some 50 Shades of Grey vibes. Okay. Whether we wanted it or not, we stepped into a war with the Cabal of Hamas. Let's start by taking out the command one by one. Valus Tarek, from what I can gather, he commands the siege dancers from an Imperial landing just outside the Rubicon. He's well protected, but with the right team, we could punch through those defenses, take this beast out, and break their grip on Freehold. Did that. Now that I prove that I'm a fucking nerd, let's move on to some other thing. I'm gonna switch the mood from sad to creepy by reading the Zenith of Your Kind lore tab. I have come to admire how you rally against the impossible. It's not your continual success that amuses me. Your light assures victory. It's your refusal to kneel. You fight and you die without a second thought. For what? Personal glory? Wealth? The wretched denizens of your refugee city? You have made bitter foes of races older, nobler, and worthier than you. You struggle so vainly and valiantly when you have so little. When you are so little, everything this universe has thrown against you, and still you persist. I could finish you, and you will not be at my side at the dimming of the light of the world. You, the guardians of guardians, if I wished it, you would die your final death, but I won't. Why? Because I'm in love.
State of Florida has asked us to disclose our sexual crimes to you.
Well, that was fucking something. But I saved the best for last. The third act, the climax, the cream of the jizz cock. I'm now going to read some Destiny fan fiction. I'll probably get flagged, but considering my videos will get fucked no matter what, I don't fucking care. So ladies, prepare for your pussy to become drier than a fucking desert. Gentlemen, prepare for that dick to retract. And to those who don't identify as either of those, fuck you. The fan fiction I'm going to be reading is called Vault of Ass by Destiny Guy. Okay. Shit, where is it? Alright, you all ready? Came the soft-spoken voice of the human male hunter. I've never been more ready for anything in my life, said the male exile. Amen to that.
Jesus fuck. I haven't even gotten to the bad parts yet, and I'm already cringing. Good God.
Said the female exotitan. His counterpart agreed. How are you, warlocks? Said the human female hunter. Sure, said the awoken male. Ready as I'll ever be, came the soft reply of the female awoken. Let's do this shit, called the exo male, and with his signal, everyone peeped out to the surface of Venus all at once. All right, I'll take the right sync plate with you, he pointed at the female awoken. You can handle this, right? Yeah, sure. Well, we just hold the circle, right? Basically, I want you, warlock guy, to take the left with her. He pointed at the exo titan girl. Be wary of that Praetorian. It won't go easy on you. Hunters cover the middle and support the others as they need. Let's go. He and his awoken girl companion sprinted straight to the right capture point. The poor warlock realized she wasn't as prepared as she thought when she saw the metal phallic pole in the center of the point. What's this? She said timidly. The sink pole. You didn't know about that? Said the male titan. No. What do we do with it? That's why you're here. You sit on it.
You're dicking. Much better than the shy awoken warlock was.
She was a titan, damn it. The wall echoes her, which the darkness breaks. She wasn't weak like the scrawny.
Hey, what the fuck does that mean?
Scrawny warlock girl. She grunted and smashed her ass against the stone floor, taking the. In her tight white synthetic pussy. Hey, left! Praetorian on your six! The male human called. I can handle it, came the punctual reply of the male woken. Unfortunately, he couldn't, and was easily thrown aside by the vex monstrosity. Oh, come on, you squishy mother. The exo girl yell out, but was cut short by the Praetorian's rawr cock being shoved straight into her jacket mouth. She screamed around the thick back stick hilted in her synthetic throat. The Praetorian began to thrust into her, creating a bulb in her neck with each deep push. She was pulled slightly up off of the sink plate each time the robot pulled herself out of her orifice, and her melass clamped against the rod whenever his dick smashed back into her. Her legs swung wildly when she felt the back pulse tighten around her chin in a vicious white squid sprayed into her mouth the force of a hose.
Why am I the way that I am?
Suddenly, with a flash of solar light, the Praetorian disintegrated inside of her. The male hunter blew the smoke from the barrel of his golden gun and waved at the exo girl. She coughed and sputtered, cum and gash leaking from her mouth. Goddamn warlocks, I should make you sit on this goddamn glorified dildo, she said hoarsely. Sorry, I won't let it happen again, said the warlock, his purple face blushing bright pink. Yeah, right. I see that bulge in your robes,
boy.
Don't even start with me, she spat. That shut him up quickly. The human huntress was being extremely noisy. She bounced up and down on her sinkhole, her lagging clad ass jiggling like mad, and her moderate chest heaving. She uttered guttural throaty moans and freaked her clit. The human hunter finished off the last of her assailants near the sink plate and turned back towards her. Without speaking a word, he pressed his bulge against her face and gently dried her through his pants. She moaned wildly and licked at his covered dick, reveling in his musky scent. Her tight pink pussy tightened around the bronze phallus between her thighs in orgasmic spasm, and her juices were forcefully ejected from her nethers, spraying the floor beneath her. The male hunter quickly pulled his dick from the confines of his pants and rubbed the tip against her cheek. With a gentle grunt, his sperm pumped out of his cock and right onto her cheek. She panted on her warm cum dripped. She panted as his warm cum dripped down her face and off her chin. The male, a human, gently slapped her clean cheek as if to say, good job, and returned his cock to his pants, getting back into the fight. The awoken girl was starting to hurt. Pussy couldn't take the whole cock, she knew. Her lithe frame quaked and her little blue lips quivered as she tried her hardest to force the rod deeper in, deeper to no avail. She shrieked when she felt it smash against her cervix. You okay there, babe? The ex-male called back to her. I'm full. I can't take any more.
Just like how I can't take any more of this fan fiction.
What are you talking about? You're still got 2 more inches to take. I have a shallow pussy. All right. I feel it in my cervix. You need to take it to the hilt. The spire won't form. Otherwise, I can't. Oh, man up,
or woman up, I guess. Seriously, that line?
You don't have a choice. I'll help. No, stay away from me. She cried out as the exotitan placed his hands on her small shoulders and began to push downward. It's for the good of all of us. We have no choice. She felt the head of the rod pushing forcefully against her cervix, and her amber eyes started to water. She looked up at the robot man's face pleadingly, but there was nothing that could be done. She wailed in pain as the head tore through her barrier and slammed into her womb. Her small chest shook with sobs, and a prominent bulge appeared in her belly. Her ass landed on the floor with a loud smack, and the spire to the left materialized fully. The door would be open soon. Hang tight, pretty lady. Home stretch. The XF's head trying to placate the hysterical awoken girl. Has anyone ever told you how cute you look in intense sexual pain? He choked. He got a loud wail in response. Her light blue clit bulged out from her quivering pussy, and suddenly he hatched an idea. He would make her feel better. The male Exo reached his fingers down into her small pussy and gently teased her butt. The warlock looked at her with confusion, her watery eyes opening slightly wider. He played with her clit and rubbed her ass gently, trying to soothe her pain. She stopped sobbing and started to whimper and shake, and the Exo started to gain confidence. He pulled his metallic dick up from the body armor and teased her clit with his cock hand, spreading pretty cum all over her little pleasure foot. The warlock moans softly, confused in pain, but for some reason the pain started becoming deflating. Not to say that it still wasn't pain, but it was a good pain. Accompanied by a sense of bliss. The XO rubbed his dick hard against her clit as she cried out. Her pussy spray juices all over her balls and the bronze tailors, ruining her tattoo orifice. That was enough to send the robot titan over the edge. His cock pulsed and his synthetic gum pumped over her exposed and blue labia, painting her nethers in a silky, sticky white. Wow, you look like you enjoyed that too much, said the female Exo as she surveyed the scene before her. Doors open, perverts. Let's get moving already. Well, what the fuck did I just fucking do? I probably never get to have to live this video ever again. So, is anyone even fucking watching this at this point?